So in this video, I want to go over the best way to find wholesale suppliers, whether that's going to be for wholesale buying in bulk, or it's if you're in the business that I'm in, which is dropshipping. Now, I've made a bunch of these videos before for how to find suppliers, and each one has a clickbait title of the easiest or the best ways to find suppliers. However, this is the absolute best way to find suppliers specifically for selling on Amazon. I've been using this in my business for roughly the past year, and I have found all of my good suppliers using this method. The main problem with trying to find suppliers using other methods is that it's like door-to-door sales. You have to go ahead, spend a lot of time trying to find leads, either using Google, trade shows, or other methods. Then you have to contact suppliers. You don't know if they're going to let you sell their products, and you also don't know if their products sell. So it takes a lot of time to find these suppliers. And what this method does is it makes it really simple because we're searching Amazon for brands and we're going to be using a select few criteria that are going to let us sort through all of the brands on Amazon and find the ones that are going to have the highest likelihood of letting us sell their products. The other key component to this is that once you find brands that you can start selling on Amazon, you can then take a look at all the other sellers selling the products. Then you just look at what other brands they are selling for, and then you can try and contact those brands. So this is basically like a cycle where once you find one supplier, you can then go ahead and use that to springboard and try and find a bunch of other suppliers. That's how I've grown my business over the years. So this is going to be a pretty short and value-packed video. Last key point is that we're going to be focusing more on brands, so this won't really help with finding distributors. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using a software called Smart Scout. I've shown it in previous videos on the channel. It has been an incredibly helpful software in my business. It does a bunch of different functions. However, what we're going to be using today is we're going to be using the top column right here where it says brands. This is an incredibly helpful tool. And when I first started with it, I was playing around with it. I didn't really know how it worked. And ever since I started using it, I've been fine tuning it, and it has helped me find some really good brands that I've started selling on Amazon. So let's go over how it works. First, you have the brand where you're not really going to fill in anything because we don't have any specific brand that we're going to be selling. Next, you have the category. So when it comes to dropshipping or wholesale, you can stick to specific categories. I like to go ahead and I like to sell stuff like home and garden, outdoors, sports, or anything else like that. There are some categories that you're obviously going to avoid, such as Alexa or other categories where those are only Amazon products. And then I also recommend avoiding categories like clothing or stuff like that where the price point is really low, so it's hard to find dropshipping suppliers. However, if you want to go ahead and you want to search for brands in clothing or other categories, then I highly encourage it. So what you want to do is you want to select the category that you're going to be searching for. So for this tutorial, I'm just going to select health and household. That's one that I'm familiar with, and I sell a lot of products in that category. Next, we're going to have the Amazon in stock rate. So for this, I like to set it to zero. Now, you don't have to, because there is a way to go ahead and you can sell products that Amazon is also selling. But for this tutorial, I only want to find brands where Amazon is not on any of the listings. So you'll see right here, there are two options to put it. I want to go ahead and I want to put it in the second option. And what this means is that the max amount of percentage that of the listings that Amazon is going to be selling on is 0%, i.e. they're not going to be selling on any of the listings. The next column we have is the average number of sellers. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna fill in the minimum and the maximum. What this is going to do is it's going to only filter brands where the average number of sellers across all of their listings meets these criteria. So I'm gonna set a minimum to 1.5. The reason I'm doing this is because I do not want listings that only have one seller or 1.1 seller or anything like that, because if a listing across all of the listings for that brand on average have one seller, that means that typically it's just a brand or it's a private label product or something like that where only one seller is selling those items. So I want something like around 2 or 3, and you can go ahead and you can adjust this. For this example, I'm starting off with 1.5, and then I like to set a maximum of 15. The reason I set a maximum of 15 is because once you start getting to where the average is 20, 30, or 40, those tend to be very competitive brands. And if you're just starting out, then it can be hard to go ahead and get an account with those brands, or it can be hard to compete with those sellers. And then it just tends to be a price war to the bottom if you're competing with 50 other sellers. Starting in the next row, we have the average selling price. So what I like to do is I like to set the minimum at 300. And then I also like to set the maximum at about 200. If you're a beginner, I recommend starting off with items that are not as costly, just because as a beginner, you might not have the funds to cover items that are $500 or even $750, somewhere around that price range. So I like to go ahead and I like to stick to more around 30 to 100 or 30 to 200. This will give you a decent amount of selection in terms of brands. Next, we have the monthly revenue. So this can be a little bit deceptive. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put around 10,000. What this means is that on average, the brand is doing $10,000 a month. Now, this tends to be on the lower end of the spectrum. So $10,000 probably means that the brands that this is going to find are in reality doing around $20,000 a month or even upwards more of that. And for the maximum, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to set it at $50,000. Now, the reason I'm setting it at a lesser amount is because I want to try and find smaller brands. I don't want to find brands that are doing $1 million a month on Amazon, which means that they have more people that are working with them, more resellers. So it's going to be harder to get an account and it's going to be more competitive. This way, we're focusing on smaller brands, so we have a higher likelihood of going ahead and working with them. I do not do anything for the average size of the product. Again, if you want to try and sell smaller products, you can mess with this. The average review rating and the total number of reviews, I don't really touch. Total product count is something that I do change. The reason for this is because I like to focus on brands that have a larger selection of products. This doesn't really impact anything because if you work with a brand that has 10 items and all of those 10 items sell really well, you can go ahead and you can start working with them versus if you have a brand that has 1,000 products, but none of them sell, you're not really going to be able to make any money with that brand. So for me, I like to set the minimum at 15. This is going to weed out brands that only have a small selection of product. Typically with brands that have like 5 to 10 products, they tend to be more private label products or just smaller brands that I wouldn't work with or that don't have dropship programs in general. So just for this example, I'm going to set it to 15. And then for the average number of FBA sellers, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to leave this. However, if you wanted to specifically try and find dropship suppliers, then you can put the maximum at 0, and then none of the listings will be FBA or they will have an average of 0% FBA sellers on all of the listings. Next, we have the brand score, which I avoid. Once you have all of your parameters filled in, you can go ahead and you can press search. The last thing I just want to quickly note is that you can save a filter. So this way, if you create a filter and you find some really good suppliers with that, I recommend saving it so you can come back to it in the future. So from there, you're going to press search and then it's going to show all of the brands that have met your criteria. So you'll see for this one that I only have 5 brands. Now for each of these brands, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to pull up their Amazon page. And from there, if everything checks out, I'm going to search their name on Google, try and find their website and see if I can actually make an account. So let's start with the first one. We're going to search their name up on Amazon. And you'll see that they sell women's clothing. So not a particular brand that I would want to work with. However, we can go back to it. Just for this example, let's move on to the next one. So here we have a brand and it looks like they sell a bunch of miscellaneous products. So what we can do is we can take the brand and we can search Google for it and see if we can potentially find their website and create a wholesale account. So we're going to do that. Here we have them on Amazon. We have them right here. I don't see any of their websites. So let's go ahead and search up wholesale. So what I did is I added the word wholesale to the search query. And then from there, I'm trying to find their wholesale website. So I don't see anything from their website. Now, if I had more time, I can go ahead and I can add different search terms. I can try and find them. But for this example, let's move on to the other one. So the next two brands that we have are Ear Gear and Melrose. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the brand name and I'm going to enter it in Google, try and find their wholesale website. And I want to match it up to the products that I'm seeing sold on Amazon. So if I go to Amazon for this brand, which is Melrose, I can see that I have glasses. I can see right here that I have a set of candles. I have a pulley system right here. So it looks like they sell an assortment of glasses as well as some home decor items. So let's fix this Google search term and then search on their website. So we have Melrose right here in the Bronx. That's probably not it. I don't see any wholesale website. It says on Google that there is a search term Melrose Wholesale. And here we have Wholesale Home Holiday. So we're going to search that up and it brings us to this website. So it says, welcome to Melrose International. New customers register here. So what I want to do is I want to go ahead and I want to take a look on their website if they're a wholesale supplier. So scrolling down, I see that they have a catalog, decorate with Melrose. I'm trying to find something that says dealer login or wholesale or something along those lines. So here it says about us, we can open that up. And then I see something that says dropshipping. So I'm going to open that up. So it looks like they do have a dropship program and they've been around for over 30 years. And right here, you can go ahead and you can apply, send your information in. And they also have a bunch of frequently asked questions right here. So I want to go ahead and see if I can sell on Amazon. So I'm going to do Control F and put Amazon. Can I sell your items on Amazon or Walmart? Yes, we dropship for them. So we just found a supplier that we can go ahead and get an account with and then sell their products on Amazon and Walmart and on eBay as well. So this is a great way to go ahead and find those brands because we're looking on Amazon already and we already know that their items sell and we already know just from this that we can go ahead and sell their items. So with this supplier, what I can do is I can then use this supplier as a base for finding other suppliers. So let me just quickly show you how I would do that. So once I have the brand, I then go back to Smart Scout and I click on the magnifying glass and then I put dashboard. And then from the dashboard, I can go ahead and I can see all their products as well as more importantly, I can see their sellers. So going back to their sellers, here I have an overview of the sellers on their listings. This one's on 92% of them. So let's go ahead and take a look at the seller, see how large they are. So they're doing roughly $15,000 a month in estimated monthly revenue, which means they could be doing anywhere from $30,000 to $50,000 a month, just from my own estimates. And right here, you can see that they have around 12% in FBA, which means that they're doing around 88% in FBM or dropship listings, which could mean that they are a good competitor to look at and see what other brands that they're selling and potentially find some other brands that we can go ahead and sell. So it looks like the only brand that they are on is Melrose. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to X out and I'm going to move on to the next seller. So if we go here to this seller and we take a look at their details, we can see that they're doing an estimated $92,000 monthly. So again, this is on the low end. They could be doing anywhere from $100,000 to $200,000 a month, 32% FBA. Let's go ahead and take a look at their brand coverage. So we have a brand right here called Northlight, Swim Central, F&F, and it doesn't even show Melrose, which is the one that we actually found them on. So let's go ahead and take a look at Nightlife. And if we take a look at some of their products, Northlight, it looks like they sell an assortment of different types of items. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go to Google. I'm going to search them up. I'm going to see if I can find their wholesale website and see if I can start selling them. So we have Northlight Seasonal. So I didn't even need to go ahead and add wholesale to there. And if I look at this, I can request an account. I see something that says catalog, and potentially we just found another wholesale supplier that we can dropship from. So that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. This is just a quick insight into how I find suppliers. And I think it's perhaps one of the best ways to go ahead and find wholesale suppliers. Again, whether for buying in bulk or dropshipping, especially when selling on Amazon. So that's going to be it. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.